guys, so for today's DIY, it is day, can't remember what day it is, maybe three, but it's one of those days of a week, 5 days of DIYs. So basically, if you haven't already seen my other ones, basically in a week I'm uploading one video every day this week of DIYs, like Pinterest-y testing DIYs. So today I'm going to be making this chalkboard phone case, which I'm going to put on one side of me, probably here. So yeah, remember to subscribe so you don't miss a video. Bye! So, here in front of me, I have a phone case. This is just an old iPhone 4 case that I bought for like 99p that I never actually put on my phone. So I decided, as I don't use my iPhone 4 anymore and I never use it anyway, I will use this one for the DIY because I hadn't bought a one for this video. So preferably get a black one or a white one or a clear one. Any old phone case is fine. Then what you're gonna need is some chalkboard paint. Just warning in advance, this does take a lot of layers and a lot of patience for it to work. So yeah. And then you're gonna need some paint brushes or foam brushes. I don't know where my foam brush is, that's why I'm now using a paint brush. This paint brush is really like hard because I used it before and I let the paint sit on it and it's so hard. Okay, so what we're going to do first, I was going to paint like a white coat or a black coat of acrylic paint. I don't have any acrylic paint because I've run out, so that's why I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to put some on the top and put it on there. I actually use that. So I'm going to put it on the bottom of this ready mixed paint pot, like you do, you know. Ugh. That's alright. I think I should probably shake. It does say on the back to shake before use. Shake well before use. And I can understand why. I have used this stuff before, but not in a while, so. It does come out really thin, so just a quick little warning. I forgot, when you do it with a paintbrush, it comes out kind of streaky, so you might want to do it with a foam brush because it will probably make you have less layers. So after this layer, I'll probably switch to a foam brush if I can find it. It's really dark outside, by the way, so the lighting's not so great today. It's really good how the edges of this phone case have black, like how the phone case has black side edges, because otherwise I'd have to paint the sides as well. So you might have to do that depending on what colour case you've got. Okay, so I've done the first coat. This is going to take ages to dry, so I'll come back to you when it is dry. If you are really impatient and can be bothered, you could just get a hairdryer and blow it, but then I'd have to bring my hairdryer all the way downstairs and it'll take ages. So, see you in a bit. Okay guys, so I've left this to dry a little bit. It's mostly dry, there is just one little bit. But as you can see, it's very liney and this will not do. So what you're gonna do to make the chalkboard actually work is you've got to do some more coats, but this time, because I painted vertically, so downwards, the next time you've gotta go sideways just to get it even, or I don't know why, it just says that. dry, do a few more coats, and I'll be back to you when that's done.
So, to prep your phone case, you're going to need to basically rub the chalk like so. This is really hard to show you. Kind of like up. Then you'll want, then you'll need, oh no, the chalk all over the floor. Then you're going to need to wipe it off. Carefully rub off all of the chalk. Like so. So then you just want to move in it. Chalkboard phone case is ready to go. So. Like this. And then you can just rub it off and then use it again. So that was the video. Hope you liked it. Hope you will subscribe so you can see tomorrow's video and the one after. And I've already filmed them and they are amazingly exciting. The next one is my favourite, so you should definitely stay for that one. And remember, give this video a thumbs up, comment down below, and I'll see you in tomorrow's video.